bloody sensible, can you?
Okay, everybody, can we stay completely quiet during this, just to get everybody's concentration going?
Completely quiet, everybody, completely quiet!
There will be a blizzard! And a storm!
Yes, a hurricane!
A hurricane like never seen before!
Oh. Are you seriously suggesting that your brothers and sisters-in-arms behave like scrubs?
We're still on stage at this point.
Yeah. We're too busy striking.
Look up to them, but aim your lines out. So even though you're here, you can. It's all no. Dorothy, everyone needs to sing. We're off to see the wizard. We're off to see. Yeah.
Come on, everyone.
We're off to see the wizard. The wonderful wizard of Oz. The wizard of Oz is Oz. He's Oz because the wizard of Oz. Because the wizard.
And that's the end of that one, and quick break.
I'm the dog. Well, I'll say a bit about going back home then. Oh golly, oh gosh, come and lie on the couch with a nice bit of bosh from Burnham on Crouch.
Hey, hey, we're the Bunch Nymphs, people say we're lazy clowns, but we're too busy striking to pour any other bricks down.
Is that the whole thing?
Yeah. Thank God.
That's gone as well.
Oh, yeah.
I'll have what she's having, please.
It's a top training door. I did it myself.
You tell me first.
Together?
All right.
Butterfly,
Legacy cannot be sullied by that frothy little doll of a girl.
Your friend. The other day, a little poodle said to me, Toto, that Dorothy is so cute.
She did it.
She did.
She did not.
She did too.
She did not.
Why, she did not. Actually, she barked rather annoyingly and peed on my lamppost. Do we have to keep doing this cute thing?
I think we do on their ear.
Oh, I hadn't noticed them. I'll go and see if they're worth being.
Somewhere over around all these lovely people. Hello, everyone. Hello. I'm Linda, Dorothy's aunt. She cuts others, but I don't really spend much time with them. They are, shall I say, in the less refined side of the family. A bit more London feels. Anyway, I best be off. There's a lot of calls, might seem varied in these parts. Goodbye, everybody. She's unkind about my other ex. They're nice in their own way. Mad as about the Brexit, but completely harmless.
Shall I get next?
Yes, please, Toto. Don't forget to cure them.
Just when we said it would, if you're the 20 minutes right at the bottom of the website under the mandatory pet insurance.
Did somebody say something? Have we landed?
No, but I think I heard a scream.
Well, I might have screamed. Have I broken something?
No, but I think we might have damaged somebody a bit.
Oh, this looks different. I don't think we're in Hackney anymore. But did the house have shoes before we took off?
No, but those red slippers on.
Well, what are we going to do with them?
I have to take it out here. Can't we pull?
£1,721.99 We could have had stolen from us. So, we've got some new actors for the time of the film. You lot are going to start laying a row, or I am going to bite your little munchkin bottoms so hard that if you have a bath, you will fill up with water, and your munchkin mums and dads can use you like watering cans on their allotments. Do I make myself clear?
Now look here.
What was you saying, Gerald?
I was just saying, I like your direct approach at the negotiation table, and if management had taken such an open perspective in the first instance, we might never have had these damaging strike scenarios.
And
I'll put the boys and girls back to work without no further interest. My kids, they let me know the bricks.
But we haven't got any, Gerald. Remember, the people who made them went on strike as well.
Gitoto, why don't you use your negotiation skills to get them their bricks? There we go, Munchkins. Get laying down that brick.
Smash them from Thank you.
when she thinks she has reached her goal, I will strike. And when I do, you had better make sure you have your heads down and your umbrellas up. Because I need this Dorothy and that ghastly dog of hers will come raining down like a nice chunky soup. Yes. I'm going now, but you'll see more of me later. Probably when you're not expecting it.
Where have I seen him before?
him before. Nana, don't interrupt. I'm going to give you a clue. Yes, that's me. Not to put too fine a point on it, the most famous liar in the empire. Now you're wondering, why did they choose me? Because I'm the finest looking, the grandest, and the fiercest lion in the whole wide world. But hark, somebody is coming. Golly, are they going to get a surprise?
Thank you.
Monkeys, come to your mistress. What's this? I'm sorry we could not get the monkeys. We hope you are happy with a replacement. Replacement? What replacement?
This replacement.
You! You are my poor little flying monkeys. Can you fly?
I can do this.
Aren't you also?
The one that plays the dog, yes. Is it that obvious?
But you're still wearing the long costume.
No time to change, I'm afraid. Just going to have to do.
You do know that Toto is supposed to fight the flying monkey.
Yes, it's going to be an absolute shambles.
My poor little flying monkeys will kidnap Dorothy and bring her to me, and then she will pay for killing my beloved sister.
Yeah, but that dick dog is no match for me. That makes much better narrative sense.
Oh, Smooth as the skin on your cut. Well, it's very might soon not have any more yellow bits to lay.
Oh, we're an actually. Lady actual. We actually ourselves.
Not the point, not the point. We are now in management and executive roles and supervisors of the lay.
But is that in fact actually working at all?
Carol says it is, and Laurie. And they're supervisors, because they is senior.
Yeah, but do they do any actual themselves?
Actual work? Cheryl and Dory. Without them executive supervising or supervising the labour below, there wouldn't be any work at all.
And if the road's almost finished, there'll be nothing to supervise
and nothing to strike over.
Oh, well, that's got to be worth talking about. Dory, I think they're learning. Danny makes me proud. They're about to go on strike. Without even being told.
It's like watching flesh in slide nest.
Much kids, I am proud of you all. You've shown your commitment to doing no physical work of any kind whatsoever. And now that the road's almost finished, you're about to go on strike. And if that happens,
there'll be no complete absence of physical labour to be drawn.
Thank you, Dory. I think I was doing very well by myself, thank you. So, munchkins, to the barricade. The road can go no further.
Sound like a station announcer, one of those central, huffing into his didgeridoo.
very loud.
You who approach the Emerald City, who are you, miserable wretches, to come here, the glorious work of the mighty Oz? Look upon the Emerald City and despair.
Truth, fella. Is that the best you can do? I'll be as green as Joanna's chunder too. Looks like an outback shack built by Wallaby wearing boxing gloves, being chased by a dingo with a crook hanging under his clappers.
Do not try me, you pitiful insects. If you come seeking your fortune, then be ready to pass many terrible tests.
Oh dear, I've never been very good at terrible tests. Some of these spelling are really quite tricky without a brain.
Do not falter in your task. If you are unworthy, you will suffer terrible consequences of your rashness in approaching Oz. If worthy, you will be richly rewarded. Terms and conditions apply, and this offer cannot be used in conjunction with any other offers or discounts.
You go in without me. I fear I'm already suffering terrible consequences. Has anyone got a potty, I wonder?
Look, if your lunch is getting a bit liquid, dig a bush dummy.
I think I'll just... Oh, no, I don't. Oh, perhaps I do. Oh, I'm not sure I think at all.
Now you all listen to me. We have come too far for too long to be put up by some terrible consequences or whatever high-polluted words that wizard wants to use. Now, you are all worthy, so pull yourselves together, have a wash, and follow me.
Halt! Who is there? Halt! Why did you say halt? They've already halted. You always get to say the whole thing. Halt again! They can't halt when they've already halted.
Right, move forward, you miss.
Now what? State your business.
I do state your business.
You did halt. My
But you always do the halt. That's because I love what? And halt is the first thing we say. But that means you always get to speak first and say the whole thing. Why can't we swap?
Swap? I'd really rather do the halt thing than the state your business one.
Yes, I don't always want to be second on speak. You always remember the first one.
All right, we'll start again. You tell them to halt.
Finish! Right. Halt! Who knows? Where have they gone?
Oh, where's Mummy when I need her? Oh, Dorothy, you tell him.
until your weakness suit goes away.
I can't take that. It's huge and tastes horrible. Oh, Nanny, Nanny, where's my Nanny?
I'll help you with that one, fella. Don't worry. You, just like a rat on a dunny bike.
Now, what can I do for you?
Well, tell them that we'd like to be film stars, and we'd also like to get better head fitness.
That's gonna be a bit more difficult.
Right. Come on, Mark.
Bend over.
Oh, not again! Right. Two tickets to Hackney, please, with film stardom thrown in.
How much?
What?
Each?
Both.
Come here! How can I help you, your mighty mendicants?
Muscular, smooth ones. But what about your mates? What about Dorothy fight the witch. But I was terrified.
Exactly.
You came all the way to us to see me. And that was perhaps some courage.
I don't think my new brain is working. I still can't work out why I was elected.
No, none of us can. But it must mean you have a fine brain.
Well, I mean, is that it then? I mean, we're not film stars yet, are we?
No, Taylor, we're not film stars. But we're something more. We're stars in theatre. You think so, don't you? Even though it's only a low one. But it's absolutely fantastic.
Thank you.
Woo!